Hello and welcome to Rajya Sabha Television. You're watching The Big Picture with me, Frank Razan Pereira. Well, the government on Wednesday banned production, import and sale of e-cigarettes and similar products, citing health risks to the people, especially the youth, and an ordinance will be brought in to make it an offence, entailing jail term up to 3 years as well as fine. The decision taken by the Union Cabinet, headed by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, also hit the plans of foreign companies such as Juul Labs and Philip Morris International to enter the Indian market. E-cigarettes promoting trade bodies, users and other stakeholders slammed the government's move to ban the alternative smoking device through the ordinance route, alleging it was a draconian step taken in haste to protect the conventional cigarette industry. On this edition of The Big Picture, we will analyse the ban on e-cigarettes. Joining me on the programme today are Preeti Sudan, Secretary, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India. Dr. Balram Bhargava, Secretary, Department of Health Research and Director General, Indian Council of Medical Research. Also joining us on the programme today is Ajay Dua, former Secretary, Ministry of Commerce and Industry, and Aditi Tandon, Special Correspondent of The Tribune. So before we start the discussion today on The Big Picture, let's take a look and try and understand what e-cigarettes are. Here's a short video.
E-cigarettes, vape pens, Juuls. They're often marketed as safe alternatives to smoking, but their cool designs, fun flavors, and the fact that they're easy to hide means it's not only smokers who want them, it's kids. And for kids, they're definitely not safe. Teens should absolutely not use Juuls, e-cigarettes, or any similar products. Here's why. When kids use Juuls or other e-cigarettes, they're getting a big dose of nicotine. This disrupts their brain development. It changes the connections between brain cells, causing problems with learning, mood, and impulse control. It makes depression and anxiety worse.
And as any smoker can tell you, nicotine is highly addictive. That makes it very difficult to quit e-cigarettes. And vaping makes it much more likely that kids will smoke real cigarettes later. It's true that a few e-cigarette brands don't contain nicotine, but most of them do. And all of them contain other dangerous chemicals like these. Formaldehyde, which is found in glue and embalming fluid. Diacetyl, which causes lung disease. Benzene, that's a carcinogen linked to leukemia. Some tests have also found metal particles in the e-cigarette vapor. The devices themselves can also be unsafe. They can explode.
The long-term effects of using e-cigarettes are unknown.
And because there are no standards, we don't know the ingredients in these products.
We don't want children to take unnecessary risks with their health
and begin a lifelong addiction to nicotine. Talk to your kids about e-cigarettes and how to say no to these harmful products.
Mr. Dunn, I'd like to begin the program with you. Let's first try and understand and try and analyze, why was there a need to ban e-cigarettes and similar products?
So you mentioned that there is a feedback that this was done in haste. And, it is a device of harm reduction. Let me begin with that. This is a very well thought after step that government has taken, and I think it's most timely. That's because there is no actually evidence of this being a safe or a product of a harm reduction at all. I mean, I would categorically like to say that, and I would request Dr. Balram Bhargav, because he's a doctor, to also confirm if what I'm saying is correct. No proven study, or there is no approval for e-cigarettes as a cessation tool. That's one. Next thing is that the process of banning this has gone through technical evaluations by technical groups. There is an ICMR white paper which also says and recommends, after thorough review of all the existing evidence, that this should be banned. Then there are various bodies that have actually requested us to ban the product, like IMA, Tata Memorial Hospital, and you know, I can actually name quite a few who have actually written to us that this should be banned. Devi Shetty from Narayan Hridayalaya, because they have been having cases. Rajiv Gandhi Cancer Institute of Delhi, then Association of Oral and Maxillofacial Surgeons, they've all said that. And then there is emerging evidence every day from USA, because that's where it is being widely used, that it has been played havoc with the lives of young children who have become addicted. 77% rise in the usage of e-cigarettes in school-going and college-going children. And in fact, the U.S. Health Department has issued a warning of an unknown pulmonary disease because of this. There have been deaths, and there have been cases against the manufacturers, sure, by individuals.
Right. So it's a well thought out move.
Yes.
It's a move that has you know, been in the making for some time, and the government has taken the decision after consulting various stakeholders, yes, and going ahead with the right move, is what you're suggesting. Okay. Yes. Before I come to you, Dr. Bhargav, about talk about the health aspects of this, let me go across to Mr. Ajay Dua. Mr. Dua, from an industry point of view, how would you look at this ban on e-cigarettes and like-minded products?
Frank, though India is a large market for cigarettes, maybe second after China, but I don't think the allegation which is being made that vaping is being stopped in India, or its production, import and distribution, which will include advertising, is being banned so as to give any kind of benefit to the cigarette manufacturers. This is an allegation which should be categorically denied of there being any such motive. The fact of the matter is that you don't wait in a matter of health for it to start having adverse effect on a large number of your population or a large size of your population before you act. Here is a clear evidence from the United States of America, about which the health secretary talked about, that of late there are 450 cases which are lung pulmonary diseases cases coming from people who've been vaping. A lot of them are youngsters, as young as 13 years of age. And six of them also unfortunately died. And when this is being said, the President of the United States, along with the Health Secretary, Mr. Azar, they are facing a barrage of reporters and then an announcement being made. It's not being done, and they were ready to answer all questions. For after all, in the state of Michigan, as well as now in the state of New York, independent decisions have been taken by provincial governments to ban it. The presidents of the U.S., and when his wife was also present there, has talked about youngsters, because youngsters being getting addicted to it, and said that we are not going to be inactive. The federal authorities, including the enforcement agency, he said, will get into it if it is established that the flavors which these manufacturers of e-vaping cigarettes have been using as in order to promote its sales to youngsters, be it, you know. Otherwise, what is e-vaping? Nicotine, water, solvents, and all kinds of thereafter adding of flavors, whether it's a mango flavor or a cream flavor, cinnamon flavor, in order to attract customers.
Okay, right.
But so it does seem, Frank, there is some people have been adding also carcinogenic material, which the U.S. e-vaping industry president denied.
Right.
He said, we don't know about it, but of the doctors have discovered it amongst people who've been brought to hospitals, that whether it is the organized industry or there are people within it, they have been, in order to get people to get hooked to it. Cannabis is being added, as sure. well as certain other materials which are known to have a carcinogenic effect.
Okay, let me take the points that you're making, Mr. Dua, to the other panelists as well. Basically, what you're suggesting is don't buy the argument by certain sections that suggest that this particular move is something that is going to help the tobacco industry or the lobby that is here in the country. All right. So, Dr. Bhargav, let me come across to you and talk about the health aspects of e-cigarettes. Is there any research or any study or anything to prove how much of an impact it can have on a youngster or a person's life, smoking or vaping an e-cigarette?
See, we must clearly understand, first of all, that e-cigarettes contain nicotine, which is in cigarettes. Nicotine harms the heart, the cardiovascular system, the lungs, the respiratory system, affects the immune system, and can affect, secondary smoke can affect neonatal development and brain development of children. That is secondary. That is the nicotine aspect of the e-cigarette. The second part are the flavoring agents and the additives, which acetaldehyde, glycols, puglygone, some of them have been demonstrated to be clearly carcinogenic. So these are the clear effects of health effects of e-cigarettes.
Sure. All right. Okay, Aditi, is vaping, like Dr. Dua was talking about, a fad now? And are the youngsters a little ill-informed about the ill effects of vaping? Do we need to put out more information?
I agree with you, Frank. I think what has been done yesterday was very welcome. It is one of the few preventive steps we've taken in the health system. You know, we normally wait for the generation to fall sick and then take, then spend money in treatments. So this is a preventive step. What I want to say is the youngsters are hooked to e-cigarettes and a range of electronic nicotine delivery systems. The reason being super marketing by a lot of ENDS selling firms, which are now telling young kids that, look, this is not even harmful. It's a harm reduction device. It's actually a tobacco cessation device. What these people are actually doing is they are designing ENDS products and devices in a way so as to resemble cigarettes. So it becomes very fashionable for these young children to get hooked to something which is being marketed as harmless. But the point that Madam Secretary made a while ago is that there is no evidence to actually prove that these are harm reduction devices. You look at the Indian context. You began your show by saying that it is something that has been done in haste. No, it is not.
No, I didn't say that. Bodies that are saying it. Certain trade bodies.
Yeah. That's what I mean. I am responding to the bodies. So it hasn't been done in haste because in 2018, an advisory was issued by the center to all the states, and the advisory clarified a very important technical issue. Let us understand that in India, nicotine is not permitted for use as an ingredient in any food item. Okay, so it is anywhere banned. What is permitted, what quantities of nicotine are permitted in our system is defined in the Drugs and Cosmetics Act. Only about 2 mg to 4 mg of nicotine can be used in lozenges, in strips, and in these kind of aids, which are actually approved by our government to be nicotine replacement therapies. Now, ENDS is not approved in India as a nicotine replacement therapy. So they were anyway being sold illegally, and states were anyway banning these products. Now the states were banning these products under the Drugs and Cosmetics Act, which was challenged in the court of law. And the government in its wisdom decided that let's bring an ordinance because this is an urgent public health issue. Let us not wait for the courts to resolve the issue because it's about the generation. Youngsters who are continuously getting hooked, they are attending and visiting hookah bars every day. Each one of us, Frank, will have cousins in our families who are going to these hookah bars thinking that they are inhaling something which is not harmful. Now, that is the catch. You have to tell the youngsters that what you are actually inhaling is a vapor. It's a heat, not burn device, but it's battery charged and it contains certain very carcinogenic, as Dr. Balram Bhargav mentioned, very carcinogenic flavors. It has nicotine, which is a highly addictive substance known all over in medical literature. It has all kinds of flavored agents. So the heat that is being caused through the battery is creating a vapor which is directly going into your bloodstream.
Sure.
It is not even smoke. It is a direct liquid vapor which is going into your bloodstream and extremely harmful.
Right.
So it is, awareness is the key, as you said.
Okay. All right. So Mr. Dhan, let's take the discussion further now and talk about another aspect. You know, several people are pointing out that if you have to ban e-cigarettes, that why not ban tobacco as a whole, because cigarettes too are equally harmful, or for that matter, nicotine patches, chewing gums, and so on and so forth.
So I'd like to first of all clarify that the nicotine, chewing gums, or they are approved under as a cessation tool. They are not, while e-cigarettes is not an approved tool of tobacco cessation, number one. Number two, you're talking about banning of tobacco and cigarettes, I guess. That's what everybody's been saying.
Well, social media has been a buzz
Well, yesterday, our minister said, it's a good suggestion. We shall work at it. That is what I would like to repeat. Why not? If there is so much overwhelming, desire of the country, certainly we can start a consultation on this aspect also, is what I would like to say. But I must add that there is this act, COPTA Act, which we have, and under which there we have been sort of taking lot of action. We have 85% advertisement against cigarettes on every pack, and the latest GAT survey shows that the incidence of cigarette smoking has come down by 6%, which is very, very heartening. In fact, globally we have been applauded for our efforts, and as of now we have 10.6% of the population smoking cigarettes according to that survey. And I would like to say that e-cigarettes is targeting a population which does not smoke, which is 95% of them, which is the youth. So therefore, linking these two is actually just diverting the issue. It's an issue which it need not be linked, but is linked because just to divert attention. So I would like to say that what we've done is extremely timely. And there has been a lot of, there was news yesterday that China retailers have suddenly stopped selling a particular brand of e-cigarettes, if you had read that. And US is also, our retired colleague spoke about, banning by the few states of US. San Francisco actually was the first
city
to ban, and there have been, because of these incidents, I think US is also sitting up and thinking that they need to take action now.
Sure. All right. So Mr. Dua, on this issue of banning cigarettes as a whole or tobacco products on the whole, do you believe that it's a far more trickier issue and an issue that needs a bigger or a larger discussion, because there are several livelihoods? Of course, tobacco takes away a lot of lives, but also there are several livelihoods that are dependent on the on tobacco farming, on tobacco trade, and so on and so forth.
Absolutely right. Otherwise, Frank, if such issues were not there in India, a decision to ban consumption of tobacco as well as its products could have been taken several years ago. The fact of the matter is, we are one of the largest producers of tobacco in the world. Lots of farmers, lots of processors, and a great amount of export earnings come through our export of raw and sometimes and processed tobacco. That is certainly an issue, and the farmers' lobby is being particularly Andhra-based, which, and as you know, we also have a Tobacco Board of India based in Guntur in Andhra Pradesh, which is promoting the production of tobacco as well as ensuring that the farmers get a remunerative price, pricing systems, etc., are set by it, monitored by it. So as a country, as a producer of tobacco, we have our interest, which is altogether different from the health one, because traditionally we turn out to be, that turns out to be a substantive farming issue for us. But in processes, in making cigarettes, we have taken a number of steps, including prohibiting setting up of new capacities in production of cigarettes in India. The no foreign collaboration is, no permission is given to a foreigner, no permission is given for a new joint venture or to be for setting up of cigarette making in India. Yet we do see a fair amount of foreign cigarettes being sold, and most of them, I dare say, are illegal. They come, they are illegally being imported into India, particularly from our northern borders, as well as some from our eastern borders.
Right.
That actually, the volume of illegal imports into India is so high that that bothers the cigarette producers who are already licensed and are producing in India. But the measures which we've taken under the our various provisions, and again about which it was mentioned, we have met with success in consumption of cigarettes, be it at the 85% danger mark on both sides of the package, cigarette package, ensuring that persons below the age of 25 are not allowed to be allowed to purchase cigarettes. All those kind of things which we are doing, but there is still no ban on BDs, that is the rolled tobacco,
right,
which actually is one of the biggest, probably not in terms of value, but in terms of volume, a fair amount of it, is used in rural areas, and in turn, that is a household industry in many districts of India, and again, that's a livelihood issue.
Okay,
so the
sure.
issues before us are of matching a number of considerations before we talk about outright banning of sex.
Absolutely. So it's a far more trickier issue that needs to be well thought out, and only then can we take a decision, a larger decision, because we also have to think about, you know, moving these people out of this particular sector into something new so that they have new jobs to deal with as well. So, Dr. Bhargav, you know, as far as e-cigarettes are concerned, is there a connotation attached to it that, you know, you can smoke an e-cigarette and probably kick the butt? You know, advertising gimmick, if you could call it
yes.
that. Is that attached to it? And if someone wants to kick the butt, then what does one do? Nicotine patches, chewing gums, are they still the way to go? Or is there something else that they can do?
See, e-cigarettes have been touted that they will help in harm reduction and you can quit smoking cigarettes. Having said that, the e-cigarettes are actually targeting a young population who have never been smokers. Now, if you look at the data in the United States, 21% of high school students, 5% of middle school students, and ma'am said it's total 77% of students across college and schools, the youth have gone into e-cigarettes. 1.5 million users in 1 year, youth going to e-cigarettes. Now, this serves as a gateway. Now, they get addicted to nicotine, and instead of it being a harm reduction, it is a harm introduction. So they get introduced to the tobacco world, and then they have become what we call dual users. So they will continue to use their e-cigarettes, and they will also start using cigarettes. There is no data to show that e-cigarettes have helped in reducing cigarette smoking, number one. Number two, the way to reduce cigarette smoking is either by nicotine patches, which have a different content and a monitored content of nicotine, and that can be regulated and monitored, and it is not that cool. all the chewing gums have become cool, but it is not that cool like e-cigarettes, because they are just like they can be in the shape of a cigar, in the shape of a memory stick, in the shape of a pen, in shape of a flashlight, you know, you name it, and they have it in every which of shape. They could be part of a keychain, they could be anything. So it becomes sook, and you can use it everywhere. So that is
Sure. Excuse my ignorance, but as the name suggests, a nicotine patch, is it not really a patch that you can put on like a Band-Aid?
It is a patch which is like a Band-Aid, yes, which you put just for a slow release. But again, many people go back to cigarettes with that, and the reduction is very, very, not very successful. So the important thing is that don't get the youth hooked onto to any form of tobacco. And excellent discussion about cigarettes, but I would take the discussion further forward to chewing tobacco. That is another huge big issue, where 70% of the world's chewing tobacco users are in India. And India, Pakistan and Bangladesh contribute to 90% of the world's users of chewing tobacco. And that is another agenda, which is an unfinished agenda of the Secretary, which we will help her in every which way. So
this is one agenda that she'll get help from across the country and across the world, because that's something that we want to get rid of at the end of the day. Exactly. But Aditi, you know, as far as implementation of this ban is concerned, do you believe that that's going to be a challenge going forward?
Yeah, I think once the ordinance is promulgated, it has been promulgated, once the act is laid out and the parliament discusses it, there will be rules which will clarify the enforcement pathways. Because the first thing that comes to mind is what happens to these so many hookah bars which are dotting all metro cities these days. If you go to any upmarket area, yeah. Exactly. Even second tier cities have these hookah bars. So the thing is, it has to be clarified whether these e-hookah bars also are illegal, and whether they will get any time frame to put their house in order. What will happen to the available stocks in the market? You know, will the manufacturers be asked to return these stocks to companies from which they have bought these stocks? How will all this work out? And also, I think the powers will have to be laid down very clearly, because the states are the implementing authorities, Frank, because health, after all, is a state subject. And the government will only be as successful, the central government, as the states. And let me add here that a lot of states that actually banned ENDS products, for instance, Punjab, Kerala, Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh and UP, these are some of the states which actually implemented this ban, but they were challenged in the court of law. So I am sure Madam Secretary will like to answer one very important question, whether the government is prepared for another legal challenge, because I'm dead sure legal challenges will be brought.
Absolutely, absolutely. I've got a very limited time on the program, so I'll try and get in maybe one or two quick closing comments. Probably I'll start with you first, Ms. Sudam, with the best way forward, your concluding remarks.
So I just want to say that 14 states and 3 UTs have banned e-cigarettes already. And to answer Aditi's question, we are giving 1 month to people who have stocks to return these stocks to the companies, number two. Number three, I want to say that 30 countries have banned e-cigarettes. So therefore, I want through you to also spread awareness on the dangers of e-cigarettes. And I think if there is a will, because I say that it's very timely, because we don't have, as of now, any manufacturing unit in India. We do have some assembly units. So this is the right time that we've taken this step. And together with the states, because they are actually going to implement, we will take the steps forward. And the ordinance is already promulgated, let me tell you. It has been published in the Gazette yesterday.
All right. Okay. On that note, then, I'll call it a wrap on this edition of The Big Picture. Thank you to all my guests for joining me on the program and putting things into perspective for us. What's coming out of this discussion is that e-cigarettes are harmful. There is no research to prove that they are not harmful. So please do not go ahead and buy. You can't buy them anymore, of course. They're banned for the time being. But yeah, even if you have them, don't try to secretly smoke those e-cigarettes as well, because they are harmful at the end of the day. And we do not want anyone to get hurt or be in ill health. With that, it's a wrap. See you again next time.